We went to the Netherlands, and because the, I said the, yeah, the Netherlands and then Amsterdam, and then because the Netherlands has amazing public transport, it was very easy to get to Zandvoort, which is where the Dutch Grand Prix is. And as we walked into the track and everything, and there was no security and there was no nothing, we went all the way to the... So my thing when we do stuff, like when I do stuff like that, my thing is I walk around like I'm supposed to be there. And then when somebody says you're not supposed to be there, I'd be like, okay, are you sure? And they're like, yes. And then I, okay, cool, bye. So we got all the way to the paddock, and not even the paddock, the garages, like, and they still have Chalker. They like, they have the Red Bull garage is always marked. So it has Max and Checo there. So we saw that where they put the cars and everything. But we stumbled upon groups of people, and long story short, like, we're talking and we were able to do hot laps, and it wasn't like, because we were on vacation and everything, like, it wasn't that expensive. Like, it was $99 for five laps, and it was very fun and very cool. And obviously Zandvoort isn't the only place you can do that. I checked out a couple others, and there's most tracks where you can do that. So it's you can just remember that, I guess, as something that I learned that day is, like, you can do a hot lap whenever. It doesn't have to be in a Formula One weekend. Yeah. Like, the tracks that are already there always.
Yeah, I think that's
cool. Yeah, that was a very fun thing that I did. So if you're in Zandvoort around, hot laps are cool, and they're fun.
I love that.
Also, shout out F1 Destinations.
Love it.
That is my last one. Yeah.
Oh, no. Okay, so I have, like, a few more than you, then.
That's fine.
So maybe I'll, like, cut mine short, then.
Or you don't. That's fine, too.
We'll see. We'll see what happens. All right, so my next item is actually for the kids.
Get some STEM.
I need the kids to get into STEM. So this is the Kano computer kit. It comes with a Raspberry Pi. Basically, the kit comes, you build the computer. It has the enclosure for the computer. You can have the keyboard. It has HDMI to hook to, like, any monitor or TV, whatever it is. But the OS is basically developed so that kids can learn coding, they can learn how to make games, they can play games. It's just, like, really fun and really cool. So if you have somebody, you know, young in your life that you see that they're kind of, like, interested in computers, or, you know, maybe they are, have expressed they want to, like, do coding and, like, fun stuff like that, I think this is a really cool project. They can pretty much build it by themselves, but again, this is something you can do with them and teach them how to code. This company is really cool. I actually have the Harry Potter wand that they made a few years ago, which also teaches you coding. So you can learn.
Wait, what do you mean?
For Python, there's a
like
smart wand.
Different lights.
No.
What can you program, Ismail? What can you program?
So it teaches you coding. I believe I was learning Python, so it takes you through, like, all of the little, like, initial steps of, you know, here's what the language is. So it kind of, like,
what can you make the wand do, though?
The wand is basically like a conduit. So there's an app that goes on your iPad, right?
Yeah.
So you can kind of, like, wave it, and it,
oh,
like,
that's so sick.
Yeah. Yeah, so you can, like, wave it. I don't know. It's just, like,
that's so
different,
sick.
Yeah, different motions do different things. So it's just, like, a fun way to, like, learn how to code, because it's something fun.
Yeah.
And I think your brain, I think you tend to process things better when it's, like, you know, something memorable. So yeah, the wand is really fun, but I was thinking, like, the computer would be fun. And it's also really, like, I mean, this is $399, the one that I'm talking about, but you can also just buy Raspberry Pi alone, and you can build whatever computer you want from that, and I think those are usually, like, under $100. So yeah, this is just kind of, like, everything all in one, but yeah, there's different ways you can take it. And I just thought, like, yeah, F1 kids or people who, you know, want to see their kids maybe have this job at some point in their lives, like, this would be a cool place to start.
Absolutely. I love this.
Yeah. okay, so my next gifts that I have are for fragrance, because Lewis Hamilton mentioned in an interview recently, and I think in Vegas, the two fragrances that he layers together. And I thought this would be kind of fun. It's a deep cut, you know, so if you didn't hear that interview, maybe you don't know what I'm talking about.
So if you have a loved one that loves Lewis Hamilton, this is a deep cut.
This is a deep cut, yeah. They're going to be like, why did you give me this? But, so the first
you
one...
You don't know him like I know him.
You don't know him.
You can say that to them. Imagine, that'd be so good.
So the first one is from Tom Ford. This is their Private Blend Discovery Set. I think in general discovery sets are great for fragrances because some people just aren't into, you know, picking things out, and this is just a great way to give them a bunch of shit and be like, which one do you like the most? Which one smells best? But the one that Lewis wears is Oud Wood, which is in this set. The set is $58. And there's some other bangers in this as well, so I think you'll like any of the five that are included in this. But that's the one that he wears, layered with the replica by the fireplace, which is in the replica memory box sampler set. And I have two different ones. There's one that's $39, and you'll get the whole range of the replica.
Okay, the start was fine, let's try and move forward. Okay mate, we might need to look at a new race strategy after that. I've got some options for you, so go and check your MFD. Okay, we've been given a time penalty. It will go against our finishing time at the end of the race. Get your head down and let's get it done. Thank you. circuit's definitely looking better than it was a few minutes ago. If we could just move a bit more of that standing water, we might be able to go on to the intermediates. Full wet seem like the best tyre for now. Understood, stopping this lap. Perfect job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop time. We're happy with that one. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Okay, you're in the top 10. We've got a lot of spare energy. Okay, to use your overtake button. Could be with us for a while. Light rain conditions for the foreseeable future. Okay, full wet seems to be the fastest tyre for now. laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. Okay, gap ahead is 9.5 seconds. Okay, we've got 4 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, people are starting to set some decent times on intermediate tyres. It could be time for us to change over too. Gap to the car in front is 7.1 seconds.
Chief Technical Officer Adrian Lee has now won 12 constructors by car.
Time entire situation is an interesting one, but I think the right call is to stick with what we've got for now. We'll be seeing at least 20 minutes of light rain. Okay, just two laps of fuel remaining now. Okay, so the gap to the car ahead, 1.8 seconds. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining. Okay, clear.
Ferrari.
That looked bad. Are you all right? Let me know you're okay.